Hello. Here we are at the press conference for the Finalists. Olly, Stacey, Joe, they're all here. They're with their mentors. They're about to come through that door at any moment. The great and the good from the world of journalism are all here, including him from Newsround and him from GMTV. Sarah Galk. And apparently Sir Trevor McDonald is here. Very exciting. And look, it's Twitter guy.
I'm not going to reveal everything, but what I can tell you today is who's singing with who. And Olly will be duetting with Robbie Williams. Joe will be duetting with George Michael. And Stacey will be duetting with Michael Bublé. So that is a big deal for these contestants. And I think that duet could be a very, very significant part of the competition. And that's what I think. Beyonce last year was a huge part of why Alexandra won. So I think these duets are becoming increasingly important now. A few surprises on Sunday.
I feel like this is the best week ever for like pressure because you're like in the final three. First, second, third, you're going to get a medal. Do you know what I mean? You sort of, it was so much scarier, but like, I feel like I've come right to the end of this whole thing and the pressure's like nice. Like it's a nice level now. It's so, I just feel really like relaxed this week. I'm really happy.
I think I just type event lead before I go on and get it out the way and then just kind of put all the nerves in the performance. I think that's the only thing you can do, because if you don't, it just goes all pear-shaped.
All the nerves have gone, really. I think we're in the final, so we've just got to get there, enjoy it, have fun, and just have a really good night, and we have the best person win, basically, so.
I like the three of them. I absolutely do. I think it's wide open. Anyone can win it.
Come on, which one are you looking forward to the most?
Of the three people here?
Yes.
I like the three of them. I really do.
That's beyond diplomatic.
Yeah, I do. I like the three. Joe's my favourite. Okay.
Simon, do you think whoever wins has got what it takes to make it in the US?
I'm going to use Susan as an example for this, because if you'd have asked me this question when I first met Susan before she won the show, I just couldn't have answered that question. And now she's already shipped, we just found out last night, 4.5 million albums in America, making her the biggest selling artist in the world. I'm not saying that just to pluck Susan Boyle. I'm saying it because until you make a record, it's very difficult to predict anything at the moment. What I do say, and I stand by this, is that you have to make an album which is quality. These three singers, what I like about these three this year, is that they're like the guys and girl who live next door. They haven't come from this ghastly stage school background. They haven't had an awful lot of experience. This is what the competition is designed for. Three people like this, who under normal circumstances would find it really difficult to get a recording contract, suddenly have got a shot. But you know, when you work in the studio with somebody, it has to come from them as well. I make records full stop to try and sell all over the world, and so I do my utmost to make it happen.
Simon, is The X Factor a singing competition or an entertainment show?
Well, I would say the same thing about the charts at the moment. If you look at the number one record this week, which is the charity record, I don't think anyone's bought it because it's sung in a brilliant way. It's entertaining for a certain amount of people. The minute you start taking the charts too seriously, you're going to end up where we ended up, why Top of the Pops came off the air, because it was boring. Nobody wanted to watch it. So on our show, I think it's important that you've got, obviously singing is the primary concern, but at the same time, you've got to still entertain. You know, there's certain shows on air at the moment at, you know, 12 o'clock at night on the BBC, which I'd rather watch paint dry because it's so indulgent and boring. And that's why I like this year's show, because it's been fun, it's been unpredictable. These guys, well, particularly my artist, is a fantastic entertainer. He's not just going to stand there and sing, he's going to put on a show. So I like to think it's both, but with singing being the most important thing.
Do you want to see The X Factor back next year, or you think it needs to have a break?
Look, we always said that we'd stop making the show when people don't want to see it. Part of the reason the show's been so successful, and I credit ITV with this, is that they have invested a lot of money in the show to make it better. And obviously we work with great producers. So believe it or not, when we actually do a negotiation with a network, it's not about salaries for the people on it. To begin with, it's how much money are you going to reinvest over a period of time. And there's a lot of things that factor in that. What show are you going to be following, what time of night, etc., etc., etc. So we just got to make sure if we do bring it back, it's going to be better than this year.